Consider this. Scientific progress and the collective well-being of humanity have been on an upward trajectory for centuries, and if it continues, then humanity has a potentially vast future ahead in which we might inhabit countless star systems and create trillions upon trillions of worthwhile lives. This is an observation that has profound ethical implications, because the actions we take today have the potential to impact our vast future, and therefore influence an astronomically large number of future lives. Hilary Greaves and William McCaskill, in their paper, The Case for Strong Longtermism, define strong longtermism as the thesis that says, simplifying a little bit, in a wide class of decision situations, the best action to take is the one that has the most positive effects on the far future. It's easy to guess why, in light of what I just said. This is a consequence of the fact that the far future contains an astronomically large number of lives. The question is, what are the actions that have the most positive effect on the far future? There are a few positions one could take, and if you want a deep dive into all of the details, I suggest reading the paper that I mentioned, link in the description. In this video, I will consider two main ways in which we could most positively affect the far future. They've been brought forward by Nick Bostrom in his paper, Astronomical Waste, The Opportunity Cost of Delayed Technological Development. Bostrom writes, suppose that 10 billion humans could be sustained around an average star. The Virgo supercluster could contain 10 to the 23 humans. For reference, 10 to the 23 is 10 billion humans multiplied by 10 trillion stars. And remember that 1 trillion is 1,000 times a billion. In addition, you need to also consider that future humans would lead vastly better lives than today's humans, due to the enormous amount of technological progress that humanity would have reached by then. All things considered, the assumptions made are somewhat conservative. Estimating 10 billion humans per star is pretty low, considering that Earth already contains almost 8 billion humans, and who knows what may be possible with future technology. I guess you might be skeptical that humanity has the potential to reach this level of expansion, but that's a topic for another video. And the fact that it's not a completely guaranteed scenario doesn't harm the argument. More on this later. Anyway, considering the vast amount of human life that the far future may contain, it follows that delaying technological progress has an enormous opportunity cost. Bostrom estimates that just 1 second of delayed colonization equals 100 trillion human lives lost. Therefore, taking action today for accelerating humanity's expansion into the universe yields an impact of 100 trillion human lives saved for every second that it's brought closer to the present. You can picture the argument like this. Here's a graph with time on the horizontal axis and value, human lives for example, on the vertical axis. We assume progress to be positive over time. If we accelerate key technological discoveries early on, then we're shifting this whole line to the left. See this area between the two lines? This is all the value we save. But don't get the idea that this is even close to the most impactful thing we could do today. Consider this. What if humanity suffers a catastrophe so large as to either wipe it out or curtail its potential forever? This would annihilate all of humanity's future value in one go, which potentially means billions of years of lost value. Since we realistically measure the impact of accelerating scientific progress in just years or decades of accelerated progress, from an impact perspective, reducing the risk of an existential catastrophe trumps hastening technological development by many orders of magnitude. Bostrom estimates that a single percentage point of existential risk reduction yields the same expected value as advancing technological development by 10 million years. Now, I mentioned expected value. What is that? Well, it's an idea that's at the heart of decision theory and game theory, and here we're using it to convert preventing risk to impact. How it basically works is that you multiply the impact by its probability of occurring in order to estimate the impact in the average case. For example, if there's a 16% probability of human extinction, as estimated by Toby Ord, in order to get a number for how much value we're losing in expectation, we multiply 0.16 by the number of future human lives. Consider that also when measuring the impact of accelerating technological progress or even distributing malaria nets in Africa, we must calculate the expected value of our impact, and we can't use crude impact without correcting it with a probability. There are no interventions that yield a 100% probability of working. In his paper, Bostrom also makes the case that trying to prevent existential risk is probably the most impactful thing that someone who cared about future human lives and lives in general could do. But there is another ethical point of view taken into consideration, which is called the person-affecting view. If you don't care about giving life to future humans who wouldn't have existed otherwise, but you only care about present humans and humans that will come to exist, then preventing existential risk and advancing technological progress have a similar impact. Here's the reasoning. All the impact would derive from increasing the chance that current humans will get to experience extremely long and fulfilling lives as a result of hastening transformative technological development, potentially enabling virtually unlimited lifespans and enormously improving the quality of life for many people alive today or in the relatively near future. If we increase this chance, either by reducing existential risk or by hastening technological progress, our impact will be more or less the same, and someone holding a person-affecting view ought to balance the two. Did long-termism shake your view of the world? Let me know in the comments and consider sharing this video. Do you agree or disagree? Let me know. Also, if you want to deepen your understanding, check out the two papers I mentioned in the description. Also, we have a Patreon. You want to see this channel surviving long-term? Maybe for the next billion years of human civilization? Consider becoming a patron.